In this lecture, we will explore what an entrepreneurial opportunity is. You probably have heard people saying, "I have a good idea for starting a new venture." Others would like to become an entrepreneur but have difficulty finding the right idea. So what actually is a good idea? And is every good idea good enough for starting a business? Now let's start by saying that everyone can have ideas. Ideas are free and can last very long. But most importantly, having an idea is just the beginning. The idea may be close to an entrepreneurial opportunity, but it may take a long time before the idea actually becomes an entrepreneurial opportunity. For instance, having this idea about establishing a hotel on Mars is maybe a great idea. Many people have had this idea, but as of now it is technically not feasible and it is unclear what the costs are. A lot of work needs to be done in terms of technology development for travelling, landing and staying on Mars. Also, psychological studies to understand how people react to the travelling time, as well as market development, needs to be done. Maybe we should rely on teleportation, travel to Mars more instantly and solve some of the technical difficulties. This might be an extreme idea, but it shows that ideas are free and can last forever. Now assume that Elon Musk with his SpaceX company is progressing well and the plans to travel and stay on Mars are possible. When more people want to experience staying on Mars, more competitors will enter the market and facilitate traveling to and staying on Mars. As a result, people have more options to choose from, and it is likely that the price of staying in a hotel on Mars will drop. Now, what happens is that the attractiveness of the opportunity decreases. Thus, compared to ideas, entrepreneurial opportunities are more temporal and do not last forever. From the example, we can see that an entrepreneurial opportunity has a few elements that distinguishes it from an idea. It needs customers willing to pay for it, thus it requires a certain value. It also needs work to develop the value, and as a result, it may not be free, but only for those who have the specific knowledge and means to deliver that value. Also, opportunities are temporal and only exist as long as the specific knowledge is not shared with competitors and customers. This is what we call the importance of maintaining an information asymmetry. The information asymmetry masks the specific knowledge by which the value of the opportunity is delivered and what the costs are of delivering that value. If on the one hand there is no information asymmetry and the customers and competitors have the same information about how to develop and deliver the entrepreneurial opportunity, then the customers can negotiate the price. They know how much it costs for you to produce it. And the competitors also know how to deliver the product or service. Either way, the opportunity will become less interesting if you are not able to protect the key elements that deliver the value. What are the sources of a good idea? In lecture 1, we discussed that the sources for entrepreneurial ideas can lie in the experience you have, especially for technology-based startups. The expert knowledge provides you with the required information asymmetry with which you can offer something others do not understand or do not have the knowledge about and thus cannot offer. Of course, it needs to be of value for your target customers. To do this, we can use the value proposition canvas. The specific knowledge you have, your offer, is only of value when it helps your customers to get things done in their life. These can range from personal to functional or economic activities. These activities are done to either solve a problem, to perform a task, or to meet a desire. When performing the tasks, there are certain pains they don't like and try to avoid, and certain gains or positive outcomes they hope to have. Let's start with the pains. These are often the problems the customer faces when using alternative existing solutions. These may include undesired costs, inflexibility or uncomfortable use of a product. It may be unreliable and not completely safe or incompatible with other devices or activities. Sometimes these pains are very clear and can be easily articulated. However, some customers take the pains for granted or do not even have a perception or clear need that things can be done better. The gains are somewhat related to the pains. Once a pain is solved, it can become a gain. Yet the gains can stretch further. To fully understand the gains, it is useful to develop a customer business case. A customer business case describes how customers save money with your offer. Because of your offer, customers can do things quicker, simpler, more reliable, or more convenient. Then, how do these gains manifest themselves in terms of revenue to customers? In a business-to-business market, the offer you provide helps your customers to better serve their customers or have higher returns when selling their products or services. Also, for consumer markets, your offer should bring benefits that outweigh the costs of acquiring the offer. It is important to understand what is at stake because it determines the market value of your offer. The second step in the value proposition canvas is to identify the elements of your offer that either create the gain or relieve the pain. To do so, you list all the elements and features of your product or service. This search for the value of your proposition in the eyes of the customer cannot be done without contacting your customers. Using the empathy map is a valuable tool to get a deeper understanding of your customer. Talking to your customer will help to understand the problems they have, whether they have accepted it as it is. It provides insight into how the customer thinks, acts, and works. What is driving this person? What does the customer say or do in situations related to your offer? And what are the obstacles or challenges that reflect the pains he or she faces, or the hopes and items relevant for him or her to consider your offer a success and thus reflect the gains of your offer? Understanding your customer requires curiosity, explaining your offer well, being proactive in contacting people, conducting deeper questioning and listening carefully to understand how your customer does the job, how the customer thinks about using your offer, and the willingness to change the way things are done today. Keep in mind that some people are often reluctant to change. It bears some unknowns, risks, and thus time and money. This change requires a learning attitude on the part of your customers that will increase the costs for your customer. When contacting your potential customers, you may see that they differ in the problems they face and the elements of your offer that they perceive as most valuable. Actually, what happens is that you identify distinct customer segments, each with its own application, use, and benefits. Now, for each segment, it serves to make linkages between the gain creators and pain relievers on the one side, with the gains and pains of the customer segment on the other side, by using different colors. To identify which segment is most attractive to start with, it will help to further identify specific characteristics of that market segment. This involves identifying the total size of the market and the share of the market that you may be able to serve, identifying the alternatives and the competitors that provide these alternatives, determining which elements of the value proposition the competitors provide and how they are valued by the customers, determining how your offer performs for each value driver relative to your competitors, and deciding whether your customers need something else in order to get the full functionality from your offer. This process of developing the value proposition is not straightforward, but rather needs to be done several times. You initially have assumptions that you need to check with your customers. The evidence provides you with insights that bring out new assumptions, and in doing so, you will learn more about your customers and the solution becomes more aligned with the needs of the customer.